Allow me to express my sincere appreciation to Jeff for always challenging us by putting us into the right situation or the right cause like this. This is a very important day for all of us and everybody all over the world. And thank you to all of you for being out here to speak for others who cannot speak for themselves. Well, as long as the situation in Darfur is concerned and Sudan, I know many of you know this is a country that has been in war with itself for more than 50 years. All kinds of violations of human rights exist in Sudan until today. In Darfur, the genocide has been going on for more than 8 years now. There are over 4 million people who are driven out of their homes, living in the internally displaced camps, in refugee camps in the neighboring countries. Attacks continue against villages, against cities, against people who may travel for very, very important issues that they cannot do it. Like, you have someone who is sick, you are transferring them between hospital to hospital, you will be killed. You will be asked which group you are from, what is your ethnicity. If you are from those indigenous African people that were targeted, then your luck will be either to be killed or abducted or raped if you are a woman. Today, the tactics for continuation of the Darfur genocide has changed. The government learned that people around the globe have spoken loudly against the genocide in Darfur. They are not only using violence or attacks or weapons to commit genocide in Darfur, they are raping women to change the demography of the people of Darfur so that the government can have more support. They remove people from their land and they are now bringing Arab from the neighboring countries of Mali, Niger, Chad, Central African Republic to replace, and they already replace those people. Like my own people currently who are sitting in the internal displaced camp or in the refugee camp in Eastern Chad, in Egypt, or in Central African Republic, they have no IDs, they have no nationalities. But those people, new settlers that brought by the government, they have national IDs. They can go to school, they have water in their villages, and they live there. And they now, they're giving birth to new children who can grow there and claim their right in our own land. Today, people living in the camps, guess what? All the NGOs have abandoned them because the international community overlooked Bashir's brutality in Darfur and in Sudan at large. Because the government of the United States is okay with Bashir being in power for more than 8 years, brutalizing and killing their own people. Today, even the World Food Program, the UN Food Agency, have abandoned our people in Darfur. Our people, as a part of the world community, they have the right to be assisted and rescued and saved by the international community. And simply by keeping these NGOs to keep them alive after they have been abandoned by the international community and they were not offered the protection that they deserve from the UN Security Council that is using the responsibility to protect in the basis of pick and choose. Today, no one can talk about Darfur. Why? Everybody who was human rights activist, who is educated, living in the camp or in the cities, who can speak for people, either killed, abducted, or imprisoned, or forced to leave the country. Because the international community has overlooked Darfur. And the United States government, in the day of the independence of the South Sudan, Secretary of the State Hillary Clinton said, we encourage the Sudanese government, in her statement said, we encourage the Sudanese government to continue in their path to peace. The same day that they have allowed the South Sudan to gain its independence, they escalated attack against Nuba Mountains, Abyei, and Blue Nile. And that the United States government tell them this is the path to peace. What peace they are talking about it? The people of Sudan have cried for peace, security, and justice for so many years. only to see harmful promises from the international community, but also see that the same international community that promote the dictator, the indicted genocidal criminal al-Bashir, is the first head of state to be indicted for genocide, war crimes, and crimes against humanity. Unfortunately, he is, until today, living with his full power, getting support from our neighboring countries. These Muslim Arab countries, the same dictators, I'm glad that today the Arab Spring have come into our world, that there are at least people there who can hold them accountable. Syrian government have participated in the war in Darfur. They sent troops, they sent money, they sent equipment, ammunition, and they sent a military who can fly this military plane to bomb our people. Six planes, those were attacked in Al-Fashir when the Darfuri fighter attacked Al-Fashir city before they go and attack our people. Four out of those six planes were led by the Syrian pilot. And two of them were led by Egyptian pilot. The day that one of the Darfuri fighters get into Khartoum, Egyptian government, Mubarak government, sent military planes to help al-Bashir to oppress his own people. Until today, no one talking about that. Again, they continue in their other tactics to commit genocide, attacking women, particularly those women who can dare to speak for others. I have this story of a young lady who fled her village with her family. Her village attacked several times, and then they were forced to flee their village across the desert to come to Al-Fashir, to Abushir camp. She grew as a young girl in the camp, but she insisted to continue her education. She goes to Al-Fashir town every day, where she was beaten, raped, harassed every day, but she was determined to continue her education. So eventually she became a spokesperson for women in the camp. Finally, she was able to speak English, and then the UNAMI troops hired her to be as a member staff so that she can help them build the trust between the communities in Darfur, because she can speak the language and she is well trusted, because the government recruited people within even the IDP's camp who can spy. And so people cannot trust only someone from them, even if you came with this UNAMI troop. When she was working there, the government abducted her from her own shelter and took her into an unknown place. They forced her to hold the Bible, and they took her picture to tell the Sudanese people that this lady is converting Muslim kids into a Christian. She's not a teacher. She cannot teach. And she have not done anything wrong, but because she is educated, she has a voice, she can speak for people, and she can speak to the international delegate when they come. Today, that lady, after she was giving hope to women in the camp who were raped and brutalized, today she is out of the country, and she is under threat of being abducted and taken back to Sudan and seeking a review, a safe review to go. Another time, in Khartoum, when the young people start demonstrating, calling for a change of al-Bashir, many students were arrested, but only the 40 students were raped brutally by security agents inside Khartoum. And no one dared, even from the international community, to condemn that act that was done by al-Bashir forces inside Khartoum. Today, lawyers, human rights defenders, journalists, either they were forced to leave the country or killed or abducted.